Hey ladies and gents, how are you today? I just want to share a haul from a few stores and a little bit of chit chat today. So the first thing I want to share is my son's girlfriend sent me a gift to which I am so excited about. She sent me from Shutterfly a calendar for the year, and I'm going to use this as my planner since I've started setting aside like $5 a month to get the one I want. So, it has pictures of my grandbabies and, you know, let's see. Let me show you some. There's, tons of pics in here. There's one of my daughter in here that I especially loved. She put in here, well, first, let me show you her. She's about the best thing that's happened to my son. She's a beautiful young lady and sweet, very sweet. I couldn't have asked for anyone better for my son. She's a very nice person. And then my daughter, you know, the whole family this Thanksgiving. My daughter, my mom, and you know, by having a good time. But I think my favorite, I gotta show you the one of Christmas with her and my son. They went and got a photo done with Santa with their dog Diesel, and I was kidding around with her on Facebook that my son needs to watch out because she was getting a little close to Santa, and she took it all in good humor. That's kind of what I like about her. She knows when someone's joking around. She doesn't take things too seriously, except for like schoolwork, you know, things that she needs to. My favorite picture in here, though, is of me and my two brothers. I'm hiding one brother's face because he does not like to be on social media, and I do want to respect that. But here we are. My brother was in the service for 22 years, and this is the first picture we had together. Let's see, I'm the oldest. My brother in red is a year and a half younger than me. And the one sitting on my lap, I think he's 8 or 9 years younger than me. But yeah, that's my favorite one because he was in the service for over 20 years. And, you know, we hadn't had pictures taken since we were kids all together. So that was really special to me. But yeah, I really thanked her for this, and I just love it. And it says 2017, it's going to be an amazing year. This is me and my grandson when he spent a week with me having ice cream together. So, yeah, that was very special. And then I shopped at holler.com. I only have two things to show you because the others are for a giveaway coming up. And I think we're like 68 people away, so this is pretty awesome. But I got her these big boards of multiplication and division. She's having a difficult time. And as we know, multiplication and simple division, it's just basic memorization. Once she gets the multiplication down, she'll get the division down. But they have this kind of like coating on it to where I'm hoping a dry erase marker will work. I'm going to try it like up here in the corner or something to see if a dry eraser will work with it. It says use number 2 pencils. Not for use with crayons, markers, or dry erase markers. So this means I need to go get these laminated for dry erase markers, and that's going to cost me about $6 per page. Because they charge $2 per square foot, I think. And these look like about, I don't know, 1.5 by 3 or 4. So, yeah, that's going to cost about $8 per page. But it's worth it for her to get good grades in school. So, yeah, I picked that up. And the rest is a secret for now. Then I took a trip over to Walmart today. What I've been doing is at the beginning of the month, I write down everything I want and need, and then I take 2 weeks to make decisions on those, except for like vegetables, meats, fruits, you know, basic pantry items, not the cookies or chips or salsa or anything like that. But all that stuff gets written down, and then 2 weeks later, I decide, you know, as I go through, little by little, I'll start marking stuff off because I really don't need it, really don't want it, or, you know, I might use it, might not, so that it gets crossed off the list. So, if you remember my Christmas haul, my mom had bought me some sweatpants that didn't fit. So, the Rue 21 skinny jeans that my son got for me, I love them because they're tight on my legs and my muscles don't hurt. So, since Walmart didn't have any stretch pants to be able to just get a smaller size, I went and picked up these. And they're, you know, they're the stretchy skinny pants, but these were all odd sizes. Like, this is a 15. My son got me a 14. So I'm hoping they fit. If not, I'll just go back and get a 13. But, yeah, I've never seen just odd sizes. I've seen, like, 12, 13, or 14, 15. But I've never seen, you know, just an odd size. And for the, I like the high-waisted. I don't like the mid or the low-waisted because they sit, they wrinkle up a little bit on my belly because I sit all day. So I went and got these as high. Not that I don't appreciate my son's getting ones he got me because I do love them. But, you know, this is just another option. And I really don't like Walmart clothes, but we'll give it a shot. I can't afford Rue 21, which is $35, $40 a pair, but these were $18.99, and I'm going to give them a shot. And if they work, great. If they don't, I'll get my use out of them, and then I just won't buy that brand anymore. So I got that, and let me get what I dropped. Oh, shoot. Come on, get over here. Oh, I'm going to fall. Hold on. Okay. Oh. Okay, Walmart had wax squares on sale. So I got two different types. I've got Winter Lodge from American Home. And from Better Homes, I got Fresh Cut Frasier. This is a stronger pine smell than this. And when I have bad headaches, I need the weaker scent. But, oh, they smell like the great outdoors. I love them. But these were on sale for $2, which is great. I think all their winter sale and their, like, cookies and cakes scents were on sale. And I couldn't take the cookies and cakes. I just, I don't know, I think the older I get, the more I can't stand the sweet smells. But I've been debating it over this one for 2 weeks, and I really wanted to try this new crochet method I've been watching on YouTube. And it's taking variegated yarn and turning it into a, like an argyle pattern. And I really want to try it. I tried it with my 100% cotton yarns I have. But the gauge was all wrong and it wasn't working out. So I went and got the acrylic yarn, 288 per skein. But if I can't get that pattern right, I can use these as granny squares or just a regular old scarf. So I got two of those. And then I found these two towels in my stash. And I love the colors of them for fall. Because what I'm planning to do is take either every holiday and make a bundle, or like one towel per month and make bundles and sell them at a discount price. You know, the more you buy, the less it costs. You know, some type of deal like that. Anyways, I had these, so I picked up this. This was $8, and this is 14 ounces. If I would have bought the 2 ounce skeins, It would have cost me $250 for the same ounces. And honestly, you know, next fall I'll be using the rest of this. Or, you know, I'll find a pattern that could use this. So this will be used because I do like doing these. And when I get to Florida, you know, I hear that these sell out like crazy in Florida. So those would be, they will be used. And then I bought some Valentine towels, only two of each. Usually I get four or six. But like I said, I'm cutting costs, and next year always rolls around. So, you know, I can, if they sell good, I can just make more next year. But I really like this. This is got pink flowers with pink hearts, kind of low-keyed for those that want to celebrate the holiday in their kitchen, but yet doesn't want, you know, a big cupid with an arrow or something. But yeah, I got those. And I'll probably use like a variegated pink on this. This will look real pretty with that. And then this is my favorite. It says Happy Valentine's Day with the light pink background, pink hearts. And it's got the teal colored on the bottom. I love that. And this has got the sweetheart candies on it. As you can see, it says Crazy for You, BFF, You Rock. What's this one up here? I can't read it. Oh, Sweet Tooth. So I can use, I have a variegated turquoise yellow and I think blue. That'll look really pretty with that. And then this one I can use like a black topper with a red button or vice versa. But it says, happy hearts are filled with love. So I got a couple of those. And, you know, I'm just like doing one a day to get everything done. So that way when I move, I have all those done and I don't have to worry about it. And then I went and bought this for my chocolate fixes. When I need a chocolate fix, I just make a glass of chocolate milk. And this will last me 6 to 8 months. And it was $8. So that's $1 a month, which is awesome. It's a good deal. And I had a $1.50 coupon on it. And the points program I got the coupon off of, I get 10 points for using the coupon. So, and if anybody's interested in my point program, I make about $600 a year through this point program. I make about 60,000 points, which equals $600. And that's the way I buy my Christmas for family. So if you're interested for me to make a video on that to show you how the program works, I'd be more than happy to do that for you. Bought some Suave deodorant. I can only use spray. Something about the other ones, you know, the solids and stuff, makes my boils act up really bad. But anyways, these was about $15. Which is about $1.25 a month for 76 trash bags. I got the Force Flex because I'm throwing away a bunch of odd-shaped items, and it's been tearing up my trash bags. So I figured with this, you know, it's worth the cost. That way when I throw my trash down the chute, it's not going to bust open, and then, you know, maintenance gets a little ticked off. So, yeah, I got that. And I went to Dollar Tree and picked up a few things. I got a back scratcher. I lost my other ones, probably hiding in the bedroom. But yeah, got that. And I got some disinfectant wipes for the bathroom. And since I've been pulling my hair in a ponytail again since it got longer, I've been getting more headaches. So I got these. They don't have very many teeth on them, but I kind of was hoping to keep the hair out of my face without, you know, causing headaches. And then I got some dry erase markers for those. But, yeah, I'll still use them. I'll just have to spend a little bit more money on, lamination. But anything for my grandchildren. Get some fabric softener. And get some rose scented air freshener for the bathroom. And some hand sanitizer. I use this to fill up my travel hand sanitizers. Instead of paying a dollar for a little bitty one, I buy this for a dollar and I fill the little bitty one up quite often, and then, you know, I use that in the bathroom. So that's my hauls. And tonight I went to church to help feed the hungry. We have a meal there once a month and I love it. You know, you wouldn't know, well, maybe you would know, but I'm kind of shy. So it took me a while to warm up to the people that came to the meals. But, you know, I've opened up and I love talking to them. And I tell them, you know, where I came from and how my life has improved with accepting Jesus and, you know, getting involved in my church. Things have gone so much better. I know I promised a apartment tour that is coming up, but lately every time I get ready to do it, I start having an anxiety attack and I just can't do it that day. But it will be coming up. It has to come up because here's the thing. I'm moving to Florida in about 7 weeks, 7 to 8 weeks. So I want everything that leaves this house and gets put into the U-Haul, something I actually love or need, you know. Except for sentimental things like photo albums and stuff. And those, actually, if I could afford a, you know, one of them photo scanners, I would do that. Just put them on a file. But right now I can't do that, and that's fine. And then I came home. We had Time Warner in our area, and that's all we ever had. Now, before I moved here, we had two cable companies which would compete for our business, and I was able to always keep my bill under like $60, $70, and that was for cable, phone, and internet. Here, I had to get rid of my phone and my cable because my bill was $183, and I just kept my internet, which cost me $70 a month. But it looks like Spectrum has taken over, and they are offering $30 for each service, which they say it includes free DVR service, and these, the price includes all the tax and equipment, which would be under $100 for all three services. I don't want all three services. I want one service. I want the internet. And it says here that their internet with no data cap, 60 megabumps, I think that's what it is. And I'm getting 50 now at $30. And there's no contract, there's no data cap, no monthly rental fee to connect. And it also comes with a security suite. So I'm going to call them as soon as I get off here, and I'm going to transfer over my internet service to this package. I had just paid my bill for next month, so I'm hoping I get a credit, and that will at least take care of most until I move, which would be awesome because no more cable bill till I, you know, get to Florida, which would be awesome. So, yeah, so that's all I have for today, and I want to thank you for being patient with me on my other video that's coming up. Just understand this is very hard for me, and I just got to get up the courage without having a full-blown anxiety attack when I get ready to film. And it will come because it's getting easier every time. It's just not there yet. So one day, surprise, the video will be there. I want to thank everyone who's supported me. I have read your comments. I haven't answered back yet. I've been so busy, but I have at least read them as they come up. So, I do want to thank you for all the support out there, because I know once I release this video, I am going to have a lot of trolls. And that's what scares me, because in order to delete, I have to read. But I will delete if it's not constructive criticism. I just don't need that. And I don't need you guys. I love y'all, but I don't need you to defend me. I will just delete it. I don't want no arguing on there. Not to say if you do, I'm going to block you. I'm not going to do that. I just would rather not to see any conflict going on. So I hope you understand that. But this week, I'm going... See, I can't pack until I get everything done. So I have to start going to Kroger and get those egg boxes, because they're the strongest. And I want to start packing, but I got to get stuff done. So that's my goal for this weekend, is to finish up the other three rooms so I can do this tour. There's not much to do, but it still needs to be done before I tackle the bedroom. And I think the bedroom will only take me about a week or two to finish. Maybe even less than that, because I think I'm on this road to where I'm picking up speed to get things done. So, which is good, because I have 7 weeks left. That is awesome. I am leaving Ohio on the 10th. We are packing up the truck on the 9th and leaving on the 10th. So I will stop in Columbus for an hour at each child's house. Then I'm off to Florida. And I am so excited. Yeah, I'm excited for the warm weather and being able to get out all year long. And they even got more programs for the disabled and the seniors down there, which my mother needs. So I am really excited for this new step in my life. But I'll keep you updated of what's going on. And I will see you later, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.